You know, in recent podcasts, we're talking about some of the most underrated players in NHL history. And this guy got to be the top of the list because no matter what was happening, what season it was, what team he was playing for, he was putting up impressive goal totals. And by the time it was done, he was among all-time leaders in goals in the NHL. So today we're going to talk about the curious case and the legend of Pembroke, Ontario native Ray Sheppard. Now, 6'1", 195, the right winger, played with six NHL teams, and also called Petawawa, Ontario home. Now, Sheppard's great minor league career drew a lot of interest, and by 1984, he was drafted by the Buffalo Sabres. Now, he played with the Cornwall Royals in their last great era of the early 1980s, between 84 and 86. His draft year had 80 points in 68 games, but his last season with Cornwall, he had 142 points in 63 games. Now, after a year season in Rochester, he broke in with the Sabres in 88 with one of the best rookie campaigns in NHL history, with 38 goals and 27 assists for 65 points. Now, in 89, he played the majority season with Buffalo with seasoning in Rochester, 22 goals. Now, he ended his career as one person that achieved a rare feat that probably will never be duplicated, because he scored at least 20 goals in a season for six different NHL teams. Only the great Bill Guerin broke the record soon after Sheppard retired. Now, Sheppard's also a multiple sport athlete. He has been named the second best golfer amongst athletes of sports other than golf by Golf Digest. Now, he also serves time of retirement as the one of the board of directors for the Panthers Alumni Association. Now, with his time with Buffalo, he had a very big season with the Rangers before going on Detroit, and that's where he had the majority of his success. He had four consecutive seasons of 32 goals or more. But in 94, in probably one of the best seasons of the 94 players, like one of the best years for players who skated in the decade, he had 52 goals and 41 assists for 93 points in 82 games. Now, it was becoming more and more a rarity in the 90s for a player to score 50 goals, and Sheppard, his shot on goal, like a scoring percentage, was just through the roof. Now, for some reason, Detroit gave up on him. He ended up with San Jose in Florida, actually in 96, and he helped Florida get to the Stanley Cup Finals and their championship run. In that season, he had 37 goals with three combined squads, including 16 points in the playoffs. Now, Florida, he had 29 goals the next season, but then in 98, he found himself sharing time with Florida and Carolina, and he did go back to Florida in 99-2000 after a 25-goal season with Carolina. And he wrapped up his career in 2001 with S.A. Longino in the NLA with 13 goals and 4 assists for 17 points. So final NHL totals, ladies and gentlemen, but the playoff totals are really impressive. We'll get that in a second. 817 games, 357 goals, 657 points. But in the playoffs, it equates to a full season. 30 goals and 20 assists for 50 points in 81 games. Now, awards and honors. First All-Star team, OHL, 86. Rel Tilson Trophy, again, 86. And 86 as well, the Eddie Powers Memorial Trophy and the Jim Mahan Memorial Trophy. Calder Cup in 87 with the Rochester Americans. And 88, the All-Rookie Team for the association. Now, he did announce his retirement after the 2000 NHL season, but the biggest controversy as well, we talked about this in previous podcasts, the Rangers picked him up for a dollar in 1990, for a dollar. So that's the best dollar that the Rangers spent, but he also lost money by letting him get away. Now, the controversy here as well, he was traded by the Red Wings to Sharks for Igor Larionov, which obviously opened the door for Detroit to win that cup. Now, he also was traded for Kirk McLean in 98, a controversial deal because Kirk McLean was maybe past his prime at the time. So, anyway. So, thanks for listening. Ray Sheppard, again, a very, very interesting career. Could have scored 500 goals, but, the seasons where he's being shifted around a lot, I think it effectively ended that quest, because to be 500 goals, you've got to be with one team at least 13 seasons, either a combination of teams that respect your talent. And I don't think Ray Sheppard was fully respected. So thanks for listening. Bye.